Well, guys, we went into the game, three, four different goals. One was guarding the ball screen. We failed miserably on that. One was turning the ball over. We had 26 points off of turnovers. One was to get them in a little bit of foul trouble, get to the free throw line. I thought we did a hell of a job on that. And one is to defend them decently. As I looked at the game, kept looking up at the clock that has all the stats, and we were shooting over 50% the whole game. They were shooting in the low 30s the whole game. And the difference at halftime, we thought, was the turnovers and the, you know, they hit some threes. They hit a big one. Simpson hit that big one from deep, deep, deep. And, you know, Wagner played very well. He gave us some problems. So you can get the Nick controversy out of your mind. And it wasn't Nick's fault. It was our guards. Our guards did not get over those screens. Nick had a help. He steps back and just not quick enough to get back there. So we didn't step up early in it. We did a poor job of that. But in general, you know, I look at myself. I don't think I did a very good job in subbing. Met some guys, Cassius for one, probably played too many minutes, got tired. On a pace like that, I wanted Miles and Jaren to be more aggressive. I think we accomplished some of that. At least we got it going. Early Miles was very aggressive, started the second half, I didn't think he was. And we need to make some plays, you know, when you're shooting well from the line, which we were. Miles and Jaren are 90% shooters, and they, you know, we missed the front end of a one-on-one. That's two shots for Jaren, and then Miles misses, I think, the second shot or the first shot, was it?
One of the two.
Huh?
Yeah, the first one.
So that's, you know, there's 3 points. Things like Kenny's dunk, I mean, we just didn't do the things you needed to do. We got up one, and we subbed Nick back in, and they ran that ball screen with Simpson, and you know, again, it wasn't Nick's fault. He had no choice but to help out. He kicked it back and he hit a big three, and that kind of changed the game for us for the rest of the night. So I thought we did a decent job on Bachman, a decent job on Matthews, and I think we did a very good job on Simpson. And I give that kid credit. You know, he wasn't a very good shooter last year. He's worked awfully hard on his game. He's kind of from the same areas. Travis Walton, and he's kind of got that same demeanor. So, you know, we've got to check better. And yet I say that, hell, they were shooting in the 30s most of the game, but when you get 15 more shots because of our turnovers, and they did a good job early on getting some offensive rebounds, that hurt, but I thought those were the difference in the game. So, questions?
Tom, do you remember trying to get the ball inside as much as you tried to today? And where would you assess where you guys are at offensively right now?
Well, when you take Nick out of there, we're not as good offensively down there. But, you know, where were we? And that's a pretty good defensive team. We were shooting 50% all game. We just didn't get enough shots up because we kept turning the ball over. And there were some turnovers they earned. There were some turnovers we deserved. So a little bit of both. So. They get to the free throw line against Michigan 33 times. It's pretty good. They don't foul much. And so I was pleased with that.
Coach, just two total assists on your point guards. You mentioned the minutes for Cassius, what you tried to accomplish coming in. Half court sets attacking Michigan. Did they do anything that surprised you? How would you analyze that?
No, I didn't do anything that surprised us. I just thought we did some things that surprised me, you know, with the turnovers. I didn't think we'd turn it over like that, and you're right, our point guard struggled today. Although I didn't play Tom that much. But you know, it was a little bit like last year when we put our point guard in our center in a ball screen. It just wasn't as good. Now, Wagner played really well, made all his shots, hasn't been doing that. Give him credit. He made, he was the difference in the game. Give Simpson credit. He helped create some.
And seemed like you called on Miles to kind of step up and try to take a bigger role this week. How did he respond to that today?
I thought he responded real well early. You know, I thought he was more aggressive, and you know, he had a couple turnovers, but a couple, there was one or two of those that kind of rolled to the right place. So, but I thought him and Jaron both were two guys that challenged to do more, and I thought both of them did in some ways. You know, we didn't do a very good job at the end. Especially the point guard struggled in the head, the almost the body goes with it a little bit, and that was, you know, a big difference in the game.
Tom, what can you do going forward if you're running the quick guards and that ball screen type back? You're not running a lot of mobiles, but what is sort
well,
of
now, that's the difference, answer. You know, when the other kid was in there, you had no problems with it. You know, he was not only is he a pick and pop guy, but what we got to do is get over those ball screens. I mean, those are basic things, guys. I don't have a good answer for you on why we didn't. We've done a better job this year. Just one of those days we didn't do a very good job. So I'm not worried about quicker guards. I'm more worried about somebody gritting their teeth and just getting the job done.
You look at the job that Jaron did posting up, first of all, I guess. You know, what did you see in the aggressiveness there? And was there any thought to switch him over to Wagner, or were the fouls kind of an issue at that point?
You know, we were worried about Jaron getting in foul trouble, yeah. But there was thought of that. We did it at the end. You know, we and they took Wagner in and out too a little bit. I don't know, you know, what he ended up playing 26 minutes or whatever. But you know, Jaron's is, you know, I was in so much foul trouble. He got that second one kind of quick, and so that delayed that a little bit, to be honest with you. But you know, those other guys came in and did a pretty good job. It's just that we didn't have enough offense with Cassius struggling. And so we were kind of like a, you know, Kenny made a couple of plays early that where we had dunks and layups, and he struggled.
You mentioned the gritting their teeth and getting the job done. Is that sort of what's going to determine this team's fate as it goes a little bit?
Well, I think, you know, in fairness, we just don't play that way to play guys the number of minutes we play, and on some of them. And, you know, I got to do a better job. You know, we got Cassius some shots on offense, which was good, but I thought we were kind of non-existent in our break, too. It just seemed like we weren't quite with it from the from that point, and we just got to do a better job, so we'll do a better job.
Coach, with Nick Ward and the two recent losses, 3 and 4 points, is it what he's doing or the teams are doing to him?
It's some what the teams are doing to him. It's some that, you know, that this was a unique thing that, you know, we struggled with on defense, and when we started second half, we were going to pound it back into him. And he had those two turnovers right away, you know, and he'd done such a good job the first half coming out, taking his time. He threw two of those cross-court passes where, you know, so that made us nervous then on what he was going to do. But I thought first half he handled it, dribbled out, they backed off, he dribbled, took it right in, got a layup. And that was a big play, too, when he missed that little bunny in there in the second half. And I think we were up one, and then they came down, and next play has been Wagner hits the three. You know, you just can't do those things if you're going to be successful, and we did.
Anything else, guys?
Coach, the team's physicality, toughness has kind of been tested this last week. What do they need to do to kind of change that going forward?
You know, I thought we did very well inside. In the perimeter, just at certain positions, we got a long way to go. Like I said, I was pleased. I wish I'd have got McQuaid a little more time. But you got to be able to guard at the point of attack, and we didn't do a good job of that. So.
Coach, it's been a very challenging week overall, going back to the Ohio State game, the Rutgers overtime game, this one. How much of this is just that's something that happens during the course of a season, and how much is a pivot point for you personally in directing this team forward?
Well, you know, I could look at it the other way. Everything was going kind of smooth, so, you know, I got to be my best. They got to be their best during a little period of, there's going to be some ebbs and flows in the season. And sure, I'm disappointed to play this way against your rival and watch Wagner celebrate on the court. But at the same time, he deserved to. He scouts Kyle's, and he talked it, and he walked it, and he played it. So I respect that. I really do. But I think, you know, we really got to do a little soul searching, a couple guys, and figuring out, you know, that you can play offense. Their offense didn't beat us. I said earlier, they're a better defensive team. You know, Wagner has a heck of a night. Other than that, you know, nobody really shot above 40%, and that's that was the problem. You know, it was two guys kind of hurt us in the same kind of a screen and roll position. So we'll have to get better at that, or we'll have to make some adjustments.
You talked a little about the job that Xavier did with that high-low offense, and then also Gavin.
Gavin did too, but you know, they're not Nick. I mean, we need Nick. And the problem was sometimes when those guys were in there, Wagner wasn't in there, you know? And sometimes when those guys were in there, Tom was in there. And so, you know, we've got to figure out how to play certain guys together on those ball screens. And that's our job. We got to do a better job of that. But I think some guys got to do a better job defending too. And you know, you don't get to just outscore people. You got to guard them. You know, I keep reiterating that I don't know what they ended up shooting 42 from the field. They get 1-3 in the second half. It was a big one, but 1-3 in the second half. You know, we just made some adjustments and did some things, and get to the line as much as we did against them is a big thing. But so I thought we drove the ball more, we pounded it in a little bit more, but what we should have guarded, what we needed to guard, and that was the difference in the game.
Tom, 7 days ago, there were people not just around here who were wondering if you'd lose a Big Ten game. What's the lesson, the big lesson to be learned from the last week, other than you can't have a team get 26 points off turnovers?
Well, 26-7 off turnovers, and when you know, they got three offensive boards there, more than us, and they got five in the first minute there when they missed those layups, missed them, then Bobby gets the three-point play. So, you know, a little diluted on that, but the lesson is that people are crazy. You know, that's the lesson. I mean, and we have to battle that. You guys, some of you reporters wonder why I was fighting you on that. I mean, listen, this is a very good team. We got exploited by two guys today. Not many people can do that in the league. Didn't happen at other times. And we're better defensively than a couple guys played. But, you know, people can do whatever they want. I mean, they can support you, they can complain about it. I can't control that. I think sometimes, like everybody, guys, I'm telling you, it's amazing, you know. I don't want to listen to anybody because I know my team, but I get caught, even myself, so I can understand what the players are. But if you guys want to know why I play certain guys, or what I do, or how I substitute, or what's going on, you know, I'd like to hear those same answers now, and that's my fault. I do, but I don't feel any different about my team, Jack. We practice well. It's a marathon. We ran into two teams that are pretty good, and one team that plays hard. Whoever asked a question about the physicality, we've had to become more physical. You know, it's where youth sometimes gets us. You know, if you look at, you know, who played best or who did they go to, you know, one sophomore in Simpson, but the rest of the guys were juniors and seniors, and they went to them, and they answered some of the bells, and our guys did. But, you know, you can bet this, I won't be reading or listening this week to anybody. And And I just, I would feel bad, as much as this team has given this place, that everybody would jump off the bandwagon. We've lost a couple of games, you know, big deal. You guys were talking about running the table. I addressed it before. You know, there's a couple guys that never come to this that have talked about running the table. You know, never been in this building this year. I mean, all I ask of you is to make sure you know what you're talking about before you talk about it. And your job is to second guess, so second guess. I just can't wait to see how somebody would second guess some of the things that I would second guess that you said as I look at it. So we're going to get ready for Indiana. This will hurt for a day or two because it is a big game to me. And I'm going to address a couple guys on the grit that you have to play in the Big Ten. And I don't mean play like last year where we're playing to win some games, when you're playing to win big games. And some guys got to go up a little bit, and they will.
Another question. Yeah, you probably can talk about what you're going to do here before you guys tell them that. Does this 6-day break come at a good time to kind of impart some of that stuff?
I don't know, you know. I bet you if you polled, we're all good at polling, 50% of people would say, well, you want to get right back on the horse. And 50% of the people would say it's a good time for a day off. I don't care either way. I think personally, in one day, you could solve some of the problems we had. You're gritting your teeth and doing something, you're not going to gain that over 2 days. That's a decision you have to make. And, we didn't do a good job of that. So we got to coach it better, we got to play it better, and we will.
Anything else? Nothing?